Welcome to the second video in our competitive intelligence series. I'll walk you through setting up a segment and understanding the overview screen. When you first enter competitive intelligence, you'll see a screen showing all the segments that you've set up, including an overview of sales from the past year, number of products in the segment, and the marketplace. To create a new segment, click Create Segment. You'll now need to select a seed product to begin with, which is going to generate the entire segment. Once it's created, you can always go back and add more products, but for now, we just need one. If your Amazon keys are connected to Jungle Scout, your own products will be shown here, but if not, just head to All Settings, Amazon Settings, and click Add New to connect your account. Back at Segment Creation, you can select one of your products as the seed ASIN or manually enter any ASIN from Amazon. Currently, segments are limited to the US marketplace, but we're aiming to expand that in the future. After selecting or adding a product ASIN, click Next, name your segment, and click Finish. The segment will then generate in a few moments. You can click to open up your new segment. Here you'll find key insights about your market based on the time frame that you select in the top right here, ranging from 1 up to 12 months. You can even customize the date range more specifically here. Do note that our team is working very quickly, improving and innovating this tool. This is what it looks like today, but it may look a little different to you in the future. However, everything that I'm covering today should still apply. Now, all the data in this segment is based on the individual products found in the products tab. Here you'll see all the products in your segment. This allows you to know exactly what products this data is coming from. Now, you can review this list to ensure that all the products are relevant to your market, and you can delete irrelevant products either individually or in bulk. Otherwise, if a product is missing, you can find its ASIN and then just add that one in manually. Keep in mind that you can have up to 200 ASINs per segment. Now, this is a great view to see all products side by side in a table. You can adjust here which columns you'd like to see and sort each column as needed. Clicking on a product brings up more detailed information. You can change the date range to update the summary and the graph, as well as hover over the graph to look at specific points in time. You can click to view the product's keywords, analyze their reviews, or view the product on Amazon. Note that all product data is at the parent ASIN level and includes all variants. We currently can't split out variant data, so keep this in mind as you use the tool. Now, back at the top here, you'll find several useful filters. Pinned products. This shows your initial seed ASIN and any other products that you've pinned for comparison to the rest of the segment. So to pin more products, just go back here to All Products, then find your product or add it in if you haven't already, and then click Pin Product. You can also search as well, which will make it easier to find a specific product or brand. Now you'll see it over in the Pinned Products group, and you can always remove pins from this same menu here. So whatever is in the pin products affects what you see back on the overview screen. So if we take a look here, we can see that our market share percentage has increased. Down below, you're gonna see more orange dots here for each of your pinned products, and you'll see how they rank against other top products in the segment. Now, coming back to products, you'll see the next group is top performers. This shows the top 5 products based on total revenue. Trending up shows products with significant increases in revenue and sales compared to the previous period. Top rated shows products with the highest average star ratings above the segment's median review count. And then closest competitors shows products with unit sales close to your pinned products and within 15% of their price range. These are most likely to be your closest competitors that you might want to monitor. So now let's return to the overview tab. The market share section shows the total market share of all your pinned products. Next, you'll see total revenue and total units sold over time. This helps you compare market trends to your own product's performance. Now, another helpful note is that you can see when this segment was last updated here at the top. So you don't have to wonder whether or not this data is old or out of date. Now onto how the competition stacks up. These are the main metrics that we display data for. On each, you'll see dots representing each product's position on a scale from lowest to highest, left to right. So for example, in revenue, products with the lowest revenue are on the left and those with the highest are on the right. The orange dots represent your pinned products, giving you a quick visual of where they're positioned in the segment. You can view these metrics over time in a graph below, selecting up to 6 products to display. All the products from the segment are available here, and you'll see a pin icon to easily identify your pinned products. Make sure to hit apply once you've chosen, and now those products will be displayed. You can view the graph data in either weekly or monthly, and you can also quickly show or hide any of these products if you just want to view one or just particular products on the graph at once. But there's also another graph type here, the scatter plot. This option allows you to compare two metrics against each other, providing deeper insights into how these factors might affect a product's performance. This is where we can begin to use these data-backed insights, and is exactly what I'm going to cover in this next video. I'll show you different types of insights and examples of how to use these graphs to make informed decisions that can boost your business or outperform your competitors. Also, make sure to head over to our website and try out competitive intelligence for yourself. In just a few minutes, you could have all this detailed data about your biggest competitors. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.